Good morning to everyone. On behalf of Orissa College, I welcome you all for the national webinar for the Department of Physical Education. Very happy to introduce a resource person, the eminent personality Dr. P. Karthikeyan, Associate Professor, Department of Physical Education, Annamalai University, Chidambaram, past 23 years. He obtained University Gold Medal in MPED, MPhil, and MS Yoga. He has also published three books, 146 research publications, and 33 presentations. He has guided and awarded 8 PhD and 54 MPhil scholars. He has taken interdisciplinary classes for statistics for MSA, clinical psychology, research statistics class for MSA Yoga, fitness and wellness for his diploma in fitness management. He has done some extra curricular activities. Is NSS program officer 2005-8, RSC program officer 2006-8. In sports, he has represented South Zone competitions 3 times in ball badminton and 1 time in badminton. Here to now present before you how to be physically fit during lockdown. I hand over the session to the resource person, Dr. P. Karthikeyan. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Anbu.
Thank you, sir.
For your nice for your nice introduction.
Thank you, sir.
First of all, I wanted to thank the authorities of Orissa College, Vellore, for giving me this opportunity to share my video ideas how to be physically fit during this lockdown. As a physical educationist, I am thinking that I am suitable to explain about it. So once again, I thank you and your college authorities for giving this opportunity. Very good morning to all. I'll share my PPT. Can you able to see the
yes,
screen?
Sir.
Yes, pardon?
Yes, sir. Screen is visible.
Fine. Yeah, very good. A very good morning to all my dear participants. I want to share some ideas how to be fit, physically fit during this lockdown. Most of the persons are worrying about to do exercises. Are physical exercises, especially physical exercises. Not only during this lockdown, in any time, if we asked the persons to go to the ground, and they will be worried. Nowadays, yoga, you know, yoga is a latest tradition, and which helps to maintain the physical health. But as far as physical education is concerned, as a physical educationist, I will say you just go for a physical activity first. Whenever you could not able to do the physical activity, then you can choose yoga as an alternative one to maintain the health. But nowadays, so many people are having very close association or they are likely to do yoga in the earlier stage itself. For them, I would suggest to go for physical activity and yoga as a combination to maintain the good health. Okay, fine. Once Aristotle, a philosopher, said, we are what we repeatedly do. We are what we repeatedly do. So whatever it is, whenever you are doing repeatedly anything, then you will become as same.
Sir, can you present your videos? It is unpresented.
It is now. It is there. Is it visible now?
No, sir. Just present it again, sir.
Yeah.
Dear participant, kindly don't present yourself, okay? You have to join, yeah, don't present it, okay?
Somebody have presented.
Yeah, yeah, somebody, yeah, that's it, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, now it's okay.
Yeah. So we are what we repeatedly do. நாம் என்னவாக விரும்புகிறோம், நாம் எதை எல்லாம் செய்து கொண்டிருக்கோமோ அவ்வாறே நாம் மாறிவிடுவோம். Once an Aristotle told, we have to keep in our mind while you are going for this physical activity. How to be physically fit during this lockdown? There are two options, through via that is via training or via exercises. And these are the two things you can keep in your mind. But you have to know the meaning of these two terminologies. What is training and what is exercise first? Before explaining what is exercise and what is training, I just explain what is physical activity and physical fitness. Physical activity, because our topic is purely based on physically fit. So that it is closely associated with the physical activity. This physical activity is any body movement carried out by the skeletal muscles and requiring some energy. If I am moving some, my hands means I need energy. It is a kind of body movement. A teacher must have this kind of body modulations, you know. Otherwise, he cannot be able to explain it properly. So it is kind of a physical activity. What I told that earlier, so many people are worrying.
So one minute, sir. Yoga Priya, kindly stop presenting your presenting. Yoga Priya, stop presenting. Yoga Priya, I have to remove you because again and again you are doing this. Sorry, sir. You can proceed.
No.
Yeah. But you need to proceed again. Yeah.
I think he doesn't know how to handle with this problem.
Yeah, exactly. Yes.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. You can proceed.
So physical activity means any body movement which is carried by the skeletal muscles and which requires more energy is known as physical activity. At the beginning of this webinar, I told you, so many people are worrying to go to the ground to do physical activity. But for them, I'm having one such a kind of suggestion at last. Okay. Then what is physical fitness? A set of physical attributes that allows the body to respond or adapt demands and stress of physical effort. Simply, we can able to explain. This is a kind of definition which I have taken from some book. But as far as my observation is concerned, physical fitness can be defined in a simple terminology, which is known as ability of an individual to do their own day-to-day work. If you are able to do your own day-to-day work means you can able to keep in your mind that you are physically fit. And the physical fitness is like that. Ability of a person to do their day-to-day activities is known as physical fitness. Now coming to the exercise. Exercise is a planned, structured, repetitive movement of the body designed to improve or maintain physical fitness. This is also a definition. I'm going to explain in a simple way. The training, the repeated exercises is known as training. What is called? Just now I told you, exercise, I explained. Here also, I'm going to explain in a different way. What is exercise? Repeated movement is known.
Sir, again, Yoga Priya has done it. I have removed her. She is coming again and again. Okay, sir. Continue.
No, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So in this slide, you have to come from the bottom. What is a movement? Motion. Movement or motion. Motion or movement is the phenomenon which an object changes position over time. So if I am moving this hand from here to here, it is a kind of movement. If I am moving from this place to another place, so it is a phenomenon which an object is changing, object or a person. It is called a movement. If you repeated movements are there, it is known as exercise. And the repeated exercises are known as training. For example, I will explain to my students when I have taken sports training with the subjects about training. Just I will ask them to hold the hand like this. So if they do this exercise at only one time, this kind of exercise at one time, and this is known as exercise. And if I ask them to do repeatedly again and again the same exercise, it is known as training. So a repeated exercise is known as training, and repeated movements are known as exercises, and this movement is known as change of phenomenon, the change of objects, you know, position over a time. And what about fitness and health? As I told you already, fitness, physical fitness, I explained. Now, just I'm explaining about fitness. Fitness means readiness. So your body should be ready to do a strenuous exercise, you know, so strenuous training program. And basic fitness level you should have. That is called readiness. And when you compare with the non-fit people, these fit people are better equipped. So now we have to explain what is fit and what is fitness like that. So the benefit of fitness, you know, the level of fitness includes some of the aspects of health in and life. The level of fitness affects physical, mental, and also the social health of an individual. Now, what is physical fitness? Physical fitness is the ability of your body system to work efficiently. So, as far as God's creation is concerned, in our body, all the systems are interdependent one. All the systems, cardiovascular system, nervous system, respiratory system, digestive system, all the physiological systems, you know, all the systems are interdependent. So that this fitness is purely based on the systems in our body, you know. So if all the systems work efficiently, you can be able to do your own work, day-to-day work, that is called the physical fitness. So a fit person is able to carry out the typical activities of living, such as work, and still have to energy. Enough energy to vigor to respond to the emergency situation and enjoy the leisure time activities. Whatever it is, when you are moving to the movie and we are moving to the ground, and when you are spending time with your children, whatever it is, you need some energy. If you are spending all the time without getting fatigue means, and you are in a good fitness level, it shows. And what about the physical activity? This is called the physical fitness. And what about the physical activity? Anything that gets you moving, whatever it is, whatever may be, anything, any movement is known as physical activity. And what are the benefits of this physical activity? It helps to achieve and maintain healthy weight. So you can able to maintain your weight. What about the healthy weight? There is a weight management principles are there. Height and weight should be, there is a chart, the equal phenomenon may be there. So that is called the healthy weight. If your height is somewhat 5 feet means, and you have to be you must have this kind of weight, or otherwise it may be underweight or overweight, like that. So the healthy weight means optimum weight, reduces feeling of stress and anxiety, depression. As a physical educationist, I can say that I felt it very, very much about this point. And whenever I feel very stress and anxiety, just I will go for a walking, or otherwise I will go to play. That kind of play will eradicate all the stress, anxiety, even as depression. அது ஒரு தனி உலகம், உங்களையே மறந்துடுவீங்க. யூ வில் ஃபர்கட் யுவர் செல்ஃப் அண்ட் பில்ஸ் ஈட் பில்ஸ் அண்ட் மெயின்டைன் ஹெல்த்தி போன்ஸ் மசில் ஜாயிண்ட் பூஸ்ட் எனர்ஜி லெவல் இம்ப்ரூவ்ஸ் குவாலிட்டி ஆஃப் ஸ்லீப் ஸோ வாட் யூ மே ஹேவ் ஃபீல் வெரி குட் ஸ்லீப்பரி மைண்ட் வை பிகாஸ் ஆஃப் தி ஃபிசிக்கல் ஆக்டிவிட்டி திஸ் ஃபிசிக்கல் ஆக்டிவிட்டி ரெடியூஸ் த ரிஸ்க் ஆஃப் டையிங் ஃப்ரம் த ஹார்ட் டிசீசஸ் ஆர் ஹார்ட் ஸ்ட்ரோக் So this will reduce, okay? So you might have have the question in your mind that so many sports persons are dying with heart diseases, but they are regularly doing physical activity. So this physical activity reduce the risk of heart diseases, because a heart stroke, cardiac arrest may be due to the different aspects. And it will develop developing high, not high blood pressure, cholesterol, that is developing to maintain the blood pressure, and it is wrongly mentioned. I'm so sorry for that. And so it is the risk of developing high blood pressure, and the risk of developing the obesity, and risk of developing osteoporosis. Okay, fine. What about the physical activity and exercise? This physical activity is a gender term that includes sports, dance, and activities done at work or at home, such as walking, climbing, stairs, moving the lawn. That is a spelling mistake is there. MOVING. Okay, it is somewhat wrongly typed. Topographic error. Kindly bear with that. As I told you, the person who are worrying about this. Doing physical activity in the ground. I wanted to tell you one thing from this slide that unknowingly you are doing such kind of physical activity by your own. So all the persons are doing physical activity unknowingly. How? You are walking, you are climbing stairs, you are working all the household works. And if you are simply dancing music and you are doing physical activity, don't think that physical activity is a kind of exercises which you have to do in the ground. Wherever, whenever the time is permitting, and you can do such kind of activities. Even if you are walking around, walking to the shop, it is a kind of physical activity. So unknowingly, you people are doing physical activity. You keep in your mind. Because for everything, physical act, that is a mind, psychological mindset that is must. So that I am telling, regularly, unknowingly, you are doing physical activity. If you do the physical activity, you will keep a good health. Okay. I have seen some of the WhatsApp message, Vadivel Mimis, and he is asking that for about 30 days to 40 days lockdown, no one has gone to the hospital, even as a headache, fever, and small problems. They didn't go to the hospital because there are no such a way to see the doctor. they engage themselves. But before the lockdown, what it was the situation? All the hospitals have been filled with the patients. Why? Because it's because of the psychological mindset of the people. So if you psychologically boost up, definitely all the problems may be overcome. And this is a kind of my psychological setup. You must have that regularly. You are doing some physical activity. If you are walking and if you are doing some household works, yes, you are doing some physical activity. You just have a psychological booster by yourself. It is called self-motivation. Okay. Then when the people do physical activity, especially for the purpose of getting fit, and we say that they are doing exercise. But you are also doing exercise. But what we are keeping in our mind, for the physical activity to get fit, if the people are doing exercise, we are saying that they are doing exercise. Okay. And some of the physical activities benefits. This regular physical activity results fitness, physical fitness, which is a key to being able and to enjoy your life. This allows to be fit enough to meet the emergencies demanding the situations. And some of the physical activity, you can be being physical active, it will build your fitness, and which in turn and provides you many health and wellness benefits. And this regular physical activity can do much to prevent disease and illness. To prevent, that is the most important thing. You can be prevented by doing this physical activity. You must be physically active. Okay. It can help you to look your best with the proper nutrition, good posture, and good body mechanics. Whatever it is, you may feel better. And besides that, looking better, people who do really regular physical activity, they will feel better, do better on academic work, and are less depressed. That is most important than the people who are less physically active. And what about the parts of the physical fitness? Why I am explaining all these things means, as a novice person, you should know what are the things are there in the physical fitness, and what are the things we need to concentrate. And so that only I am explaining a vast thing. One is health-related physical fitness, and another one is skill-related physical fitness, or it is otherwise known as performance-related physical fitness. There are two parts. This health-related physical fitness variables will help you to stay healthy. If you want to maintain the health, and you have to keep all these health-related physical fitness variables. And while you are coming to the skill-related or performance-related physical fitness variables, it helps you to perform well in some of the specific sports and activities, which requires certain skills. So that only skill related or performance related. Okay. First, we'll see one by one. What are the health related physical fitness variables, and how I can able to keep all these the health related physical fitness variables to maintain the health? Generally, health related physical fitness variables are known as the thing with the physical capacities that contributes to health. So as I explained to you already, the variables which are closely related or associated to maintain the health of an individual is known as health related physical fitness variables. Anbu sir.
Okay, I'll be good about it. Okay. Please stop
joking,
sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Hello. No. I think he is speaking something, you know.
Portal.
Kishore.
Okay, sir.
Just a minute, sir.
Yeah, please.
Ask him to Kishore. Yes, sir.
The first one in health related physical fitness variable is cardio respiratory endurance. Cardio means heart, respiratory means lungs. Okay, respiratory system. So when the circulatory system and the respiratory system are working together, background they are speaking, no?
I muted them, so you can continue, sir.
Please, thank you. So as far as this health related is concerned, the first variable is cardiorespiratory endurance. Cardiorespiratory endurance is closely associated with the two systems of the body. One is a circulatory system and one is a respiratory system. Circulatory respiratory combines and develop a quality which is called cardiorespiratory endurance. In generally, cardiorespiratory endurance may be defined as ability of the person to do a particular work for a prolonged period of time. But as a technical, the ability of the body to perform prolonged and large muscle dynamic exercise to moderate to high intensity levels. This is called the technical definition. But as far as my observation is concerned, cardiorespiratory endurance is an ability of a person to do work for a prolonged period of time without getting fatigued. If you can. So this quality is purely based on the lung capacity. When the lung capacity is increased, then endurance will be increased. Lung is closely associated with the respiratory system. When the lung capacity increased, then if you do some of the exercises, more training program, then the lung capacity will be increased. And when the lung capacity is increased, from the heart, more blood will be purified in the lungs, because the purification of blood is taking place only in the lungs. After that only, it will be sent to the heart, and from the heart, then it will be distributed to the various parts of the body. So when the amount of lung capacity, the capacity of the lung is increased, definitely the purification of blood process will be more, so that the endurance, the one can able to do the work for a prolonged period of time without getting fatigued. And the second one is muscular strength. Muscular strength, it is not depending upon the person, it depends upon the muscle. Muscular strength, it ability of a muscle to overcome given resistance is known as muscular strength. If I can able to lift some amount of weight, okay, even as a chair, even the table, if I can able to lift it, what it means? My arm muscle is overcoming the particular given resistance. So, as a human being, we all have all these health-related physical fitness component by birth. At the basic level of muscular strength we have, you might have seen the people in the village, they were able to carry more weight. As a woman, she would have able to carry two parts, one is in the hip area and one is in the head one. So that she can able to carry two pots means how much strength she have. And if she lifted that two pots for about half a kilometer or 300 meters or a kilometer, it is known as muscular endurance. So ability to overcome that particular resistance known as muscular strength, and ability to overcome the given resistance for a prolonged period of time means that's called muscular endurance. It also depends upon the muscle. So that only in the name itself it has been given, the muscular endurance and the muscular strength. The ability of a muscle to overcome the given resistance is known as muscular strength. The ability of a muscle to overcome the resistance for a prolonged period of time means it is known as muscular endurance. So here some of the technical terms here. So the technical definition and the ability of a muscle or group of muscle to remain contracted. Contracted means shrinking, shortening of the muscle. So if it is shortening and lengthening means the movement takes place. Definitely more energy will be there. More energy is needed. If the muscle are working for a prolonged period of time, definitely that is what is muscular endurance. And what about the flexibility? The range of motion in a joint or flexibility, அப்படின்னு சொல்லிட்டாலே நம்ம மைண்ட் உடனே இம்மிடியட்லி வாட் வி ஹாவ் டு கீப் யுவர் மைண்ட் தட் ஜாயிண்ட். யூ ஷுட் நாட் மெஷர் த ஃபிளெக்சிபிலிட்டி இன் த அப்டமின் ஏரியா, இன் த தை ஏரியா, தட் இஸ் நாட் ஃபிளெக்சிபிலிட்டி. Flexibility is only meant with a joint. A wide range of motion at the joints is known as flexibility. The joint means when two bones are getting together, it is called a joint. In that joint, that two bones are together with the ligaments. So that ligaments are in a nature of elastic nature. So elasticity should be developed. So that elasticity of the ligaments at the joints are known as flexibility. Then the body composition. The last one is body composition. The proportion of fat. When the body composition, if you come across the word body composition, the main thing what you have to keep in mind is percent body fat, then lean body mass and body mass index. Here, percent body fat is the simple concept which you can able to understand. The amount of fat in your body, how much percentage you may have, okay? So these are the five components or the five variables which are known as health related physical fitness variables: cardiovascular endurance, muscular strength, muscular endurance, flexibility, and body composition. And how we can be able to do some of the exercises, okay? And for cardiovascular endurance, if you go for a 30 minutes of walking or jogging, whatever it is, definitely the continuous run will help you to improve cardiovascular endurance. So these are the some of the health related. As a sportsman, if you want to excel more in the sports, you need more cardiovascular endurance. But as a common man, if you want to maintain your health, so that only I suggested to go for only 30 minutes of walking. But 30 minutes of jogging continuously, it is not possible for the normal man. Okay. And the muscular strength. The best way to improve muscular strength is to go for weighting. Sir, one very big problem for me. What? I couldn't find out some of the weights in my home because I am struggling to get food. but I couldn't be able to get the weight training equipment. The cost is more. Then even if I want to join in the gym, I have to pay more. So I couldn't be able to join in the gym also. So what we have to do? Some of the WhatsApp video you made, a parent or the father will do some strength training with his child by lifting his child. It's a kind of weight training, you know. Or otherwise, if you do jumping, it is called a own body weight training. Generally, it is called plyometry training, or otherwise, it is called own body weight training. You are lifting your body, you are moving, and you are lifting, you know. And some of the objects you may have, some of the bricks you may have tied with a rope, you can do some of the exercises, no problem. And the irumbula vannada weight training, abundra concept. Whatever, you can use some of the objects also. But it should give some resistance. That is the main thing. And what about the muscular endurance? If you do that particular exercises in the weight training for a prolonged period, definitely this muscular endurance will be developed. Or otherwise, this weight training and that endurance training should be combined. Okay. And after that, I am going to explain about the power. Okay. As far as power is concerned, the combination of speed and strength is known as power. You have to do some speed workout and you have to do some strength workout. Strength and speed. First strength say no, at the speed say no, it will convert into by that this muscular endurance. You have to do some weight training and you have to go for a endurance training. Okay, and definitely it will develop. And as far as flexibility is concerned, the best way to improve flexibility is to go for some stretching exercises. Stretching exercises, especially stretching exercises, meaning you have to keep a particular stretching position for about 8 seconds. Okay. So that is technically called as stretch and hold. If you are keeping, if you are moving the hand sideward and if you are making a wide range and you have to hold that position for 8 seconds. And if you stretch and hold, definitely this flexibility will be improved. I told you, you know, the elasticity of the ligament will be improved. And as far as body composition is concerned, you must be aware of your person body fat. Okay. There is a particular equipment, skin fold caliper, to measure the body fat. But most of the persons couldn't be able to check with the fat, that is a skin fold caliper. But what we can able to do, weight, height, chart, you can get from the net and you can able to compare yourself. Okay, yeah. Fine. So this is about health related physical fitness components. And as far as performance related or skill related physical fitness component, which is not necessary, okay, which is not necessary only for the persons who want to maintain the health. But the person who want to excel in the specific activity or the sports, they need this quality, SPRABC, speed, power, reaction time, agility, balance, and coordination. So these qualities are needed for those who want to excel in specific sport. What is the speed? Speed is a quality, ability to make successive movement in a shortest possible time. So shortest possible time, adhigamana dooratha koracha nerathila nam kadakkanum. We have to complete the maximum distance with the shortest possible time. This ability is known as speed. As I told you already, power is the combination of strength and speed. So it can be explained as explosive power. The person who are doing this charge, you know, there is a equipment, okay. So that person is doing some sort of power workouts, okay. He is doing speed training and also he will combine with the strength training. So what is about reaction time? Reaction time is a stimuli. Are the ability of a person to react for the stimuli. As a sportsman, I would able to quote an example in the sprinting event. At the starting point, you might have seen this reaction time. In the starting, the athlete is getting move after getting the signal from the starter. So the time duration between the starter's signal and the starting of the movement of the athlete is known as reaction time. So this is a specific quality which is needed for a sprinter. And for a volleyball player, so he also needs some reaction time to react with the ball. If the opposition player is striking a ball, then he has to react himself to block so that specific activity needs these qualities. Agility. As a football player, one must need this agility much. Agility is nothing but ability of a person to make successive movement in a different directions. So here and there he has to move. Ability of a person to change the directions suddenly is known as agility. So hockey, football, and even coco, kabaddi, they need more agility. Then as far as balance and coordination. Balance is concerned, some gymnastic activities are needed. Okay. Ability to maintain the posture is known as balance. Right? And as far as coordination is concerned, it is somewhat related with the two systems, that is eye-hand coordination. Eye should be see and the hand should be moved. Okay. Both the thing should correlate with that, so that only it is called the coordination. As far as this skill-related physical fitness are concerned, if you want to do the workout, no problem. Or otherwise, you need to have these five qualities to maintain your health, to maintain physically fit. Okay. Then before that, before starting the training program, now you had a very clear idea about the variables, list of variables, and a list of qualities to be, that is, which is necessary to maintain the health and which is necessary to what it is called, specific skill, related with the skill. And now, some of the sports training principles you need to know. One is specificity. First principle is specificity. Second principle is overload. Third principle is reversibility. Why I am explaining these three principles for the novice person? I am thinking that, but most of the sports persons are attending the seminar, webinar, but I'm always keeping the, I'm focusing about the novice persons, okay? And they should know these principles before going for a training program. If you wanted to do the exercises to maintain your health, you need to know. First one is principles of specificity. What is called as specificity? Specificity is an individuality. Individuality means, very simple one. As our elders are telling, you know, five fingers are not same. Aindhu varalum ore maari irukka. We should not adopt the same training for all the persons. If you are taking the workout from somebody, it will not give a good results to you. Why? Training should be done with individually. The training program should be prepared individually. So as far as chicken is concerned, I like to have more. As far as mutton is concerned, I didn't like to have more mutton. But what about other person? Maybe vice versa. So every person may have some unique quality or individuality. As far as this training is concerned, the adaptability will be varied from person to person. So that when you are preparing a training program, you should be specific, your training should be specifically designed. The next one is overload. When you are going for a training program, you also need this overload as a compulsory. I would suggest my research scholars to adopt this overload principle as a must to know the real effect. If they want to have the effect of a particular training program, they should adopt overload. A simple concept I could be able to quote: every day you are eating only two chapatis, you will not get grow. You will not be improved and you will not get the good muscles. First one, two chapatis. Second week, 2.5 chapatis. And third week, 3 chapatis. Like that, you have to increase the amount. It is based on the need. So when you are growing, your system need more energy so that all the diet should be increased. This is a kind of overload. When I am starting with a 60% intensity, I need to improve or increase 65 in the next week, 70 in the next week. Oh, you must know the intensity, no? What is intensity? Intensity is a hardness of the training, hardness of exercise. If a particular exercise is very hard, that is called intensity is more. If you do some sort of exercises in a very easiest manner, that shows the intensity is less. So very simple, I can give another example. If you eat one idli, that will be a low intensity. If you eat 10 idlis, that will be high intensity. If you eat 5 idlis, that will be a moderate intensity. So amount of hardness will decide the intensity. Here, the overload means you have to make it overload with 2 or 5% minimum to get improvement. So this overload principle is based on...
Sir, excuse me, sir. Sir, sorry to interrupt. Sir, one person is presenting. I'll just remove him. Just hold on. Saravanan, can you please stop presenting? Saravanan, can you hear me? Can you stop presenting? Or else I need to remove you.
Mr. Saravanan, please listen here. Yes, sir.
Sir, I will remove him, sir. You just
yeah, please. And sir, shall I take another 20
minutes? Yes, sir.
Yeah. Yes, sir.
So this overload principle, it depends on FITT principle. F stands for frequency. Frequency means how often you have to do. I stands for intensity. Just now I told you, know, how hard you are working. The time, T stands for time. How long duration, the duration of the training program will decide this overload. If the prolonged period of time you are doing, the intensity should be less. A very short duration you are doing, the intensity should be high. Okay. And as far as type of activity, so the mode of activity will also decide this overload. The second principle is, or third one, irreversibility. Some of the font has been changed while I have transferred the file from my desktop to the laptop, so that only the reversibility, some of the font has been changed. Okay, fine. Sorry for that. So reversibility, what is called reversibility? First one is specificity, and one is overload. Third one is reversibility. Very easiest example I can able to quote. I would remember when our Indian teams are playing more number of matches regularly, and at a certain stage they lost all the matches continuously. On those times, that is when I was doing PhD at 2004, when I was doing PhD, this point has been taken out, so that only for my study this reversibility also have been included. What is the concept of reversibility means? When you are going for a training program, at one point you will get some monotonous, you will be bored. A person who is admitted in the hospital, he or she will hate idli and jini, sugar. And he or she will hate some of the apples, bread, everything. Okay. So the traditional food, they will be very eager to eat traditional food. Why? Because he got some monotonous about the food. Like that, in the training program, some of the monotonous will come. At that juncture, at that point, we need to reduce the intensity level. Even up to 50%, you can get it back. Here I am not mentioning that, because the last point you may have seen, the amount of intensity and duration must be decided by the coach or trainer. He has to fix how much amount of rest is needed, how much amount of intensity may be reduced. Okay, so the reversibility is like a just rest, or it is like reducing the intensity. So these three principles you need to have when you are going for training program, training schedule. Fine. You can able to design your own exercise program. So just now we are entering into our main topic, how to be physically fit during this lockdown. You must follow this SMART principle. SMART principle means you have to set the goal. Your goal should be specific, that is called S, and your goal should be measurable, and your goal should be attainable, and your goal should be realistic, and your goal should be time frame specific. And you have to follow this SMART principle for setting your goal. Before that, I mentioned what about fitness management assessment. Why we need to assess the fitness at the earlier itself? Then only you can able to notice the amount of improvement. So the level of improvement may be measured with a pre-test score, that is before the training program, what amount of quality we have, what the real quality we have. And after this training program, if you take this post test, you can able to compare, so that only the fitness assessment must be there while you are entering into the program. But during this lockdown, if this is not possible, but you can able to set the goal. Your goal should be specific, maintain the health, or in specific nature, okay, and it should be measurable. Means fitness assessment should be there. It should be measurable. So you can able to think wider ideas. You can able to have wider idea, but if it is not attainable, then useless. Okay, so if I am thinking about the international webinar which I am going to organize soon, if I am asking, sorry, if I am keeping in my mind to have our president as a chief guest for my webinar, is it attainable? So for this webinar, it is not attainable. They will not. Very grand government function, but as far as my part is concerned, it will not be. So in a very simple manner, I explain it. Your target or the goal should be attainable and also realistic and time frame specific. Then you must keep these SMART principles in your mind before training, before designing your own exercises. And when you are choosing the activities, it should be a balanced program. So all the health related physical fitness qualities, you have to compensate. You have to think to improve. Okay. So that we have to be there. And here I want to explain one terminology. Lifetime activity and lifetime fitness. What is lifetime activity and what is lifetime fitness? When you are doing fitness physical activity for a prolonged period up to your end of your life, that is called a lifetime activity. If you are keeping your fitness up to your end of your life, it is called a lifetime fitness. And I have seen some of the WhatsApp video where the person who crossed more than 85, he has done, and he and his friend has done a gymnastic movements in the America's Got Talent program. That is called lifetime fitness. Even though at the age of, after crossing 85 years, still they are maintaining their fitness, means that is called lifetime fitness. Still, if they can be able to do the physical activity, means that is called the lifetime physical activity. See here, some of the person who were, that is the old lady, is getting walking, you know. She is doing some physical, that is lifetime activity. Okay, so these are the steps for the lifetime fitness. First, doing physical activity regularly, and you must be getting fit, and regular and periodical self-assessment should be there. Based on the self-assessment, some of the self-planning or modification in your plan should be there, and that plan should be a lifetime activity. From that lifetime activity, you can keep lifetime fitness. Okay, so what about the lifetime activity? For health promotion, you may engage an equivalent of 30 minutes or more of brisk walking on most of the days. Just keep in mind that if you can't be able to go for walking for a day or for a week, no problem. Don't lose your confidence. It is not like that you have dropped out the training. You just skip your training. Because of the unavoidable circumstances, you have skipped. You try to have 30 minutes of brisk walking on most of the days, whatever the possibility. As far as my PhD topic is concerned, detraining program. There is a concept, detraining program. Detraining means stopping the training. Training, detraining, and retraining. Training means giving a specific training program for particular students. That is called training. Detraining means you have to stop the specific training which you are providing to them, completely you have to stop. That's called the detain. Another retain means after stopping this training, you have to again restart. It's called retain. In the middle, detraining concept, what it shows means when you are stopping the training, you lose the qualities, whatever you gained through training. Then if you use, you will gain. If you disuse, you will lose. Okay. So use and disuse theory is there. For the health promotion, if you skip for a day or a week, it will not influence your fitness level. Don't worry. Minimum of a month, minimum of 21 days, nearly 21 days. So after 21 days, all the qualities which you have gained through training program will be to the basic level. So if you skip the training program for a day or for a week, no problem. You know, just go for most of the days. And what about this weight management? So you have to do the exercises for 60 minutes, okay, to prevent from unhealthy weight gain. So a person is getting, during this lockdown, most of the persons are like put more weight, okay. Why? Because the activity have been missed and we have been restricted not to go outside. So that definitely the weight will be gained. So that if you do this, some of the physical activity, it is weight gain will be prevented. Moreover, weight loss will always not be there. Why? Because if you take equal input and equal output, no weight loss will be there. If you reduce the input, if you take a small amount of very little calories of food, and you are doing more exercise, more activity, then it is not equal one. So then your weight will be lost. So if you have the balanced one, equal input and equal output, definitely you will not lose your weight. And these are the things which I have taken from the net. And washing and waxing a car for 45 to 60 minutes, just see, it is less vigorous. So you are not going to do all those these works as a vigorous one. Very simply, humbly, you are going to do and washing and waxing a car, washing windows or floors, and playing volleyball. So fun, for fun we are doing. And like that, if you go to the more vigorous, stair walking for 15 minutes, especially you are climbing the stairs, means you will get some vigor, you know. But even for 15 minutes itself, you will get tired because it is a vigor. If you are washing your car for 40 minutes, is somewhat less vigor. Okay. So you can choose the moderate amount at the first. As I told you earlier, you know, 1 idli, 5 idli and 10 idlis. 1 idli is a low intensity. 5 idlis are moderate intensity. And 10 idlis are high intensity. So you choose. You can choose the tiredness, level of tiredness you may have seen. And you should start with a moderate amount of physical activity. And you just keep in mind that this lifestyle, physical activity and lifetime physical activity can improve the health, but not fitness. If you want to improve your fitness, and you must have a structured program. Okay. And how much physical activity is enough? I told you, no? As I told, you should start with moderate intensity and you may go up to high intensity. And you can do continuous or intermittent. Intermittent means breaking up in between. Okay, some intervals will be there. Then low intensity exercise improves health, but may not improve your specific skill-related variables. So you have to be taken care of more number of sorry, more intensity to improve our fitness. It will maintain. Okay, here some of the physical activity pyramid is there. So you can do some of the selected activities. That is, you know, watching the television, surfing the net, and talking to the telephone. You can list it. You can spend a little bit time. And you're going for the strength training, flexible training, a little bit time more. When you are going for a cardio sport endurance, it will be more than the resting strength training and flexible training. And some of the cleaning of walking, cleaning your house, and some of the household work means moderate intensity work, and you can have more. Okay, so more moderate intensity physical activity, some of the next cardiovascular endurance activity, then strength training, and a little bit watching television, surfing internet, and talking to the telephone. But as far as my observation is concerned, it is totally in the reverse way. Okay, we are spending more in the watching television, surfing internet, and talking to the phone. And strength training and the cardio strength, and all the household works, we are doing very little bit because we are sharing. And what are the suggested formats of exercising? And you should start with the stretching exercises as a warming exercises, because when you make all the systems ready, then only your body is ready to go for strenuous exercises, which will help you to prevent from the injuries. Okay, always you should start with the stretching exercises as warming up exercises, which is called some of the stretching exercises. Okay, then do walking or jogging for 30 minutes. I told you, you know, moderate intensity work, if you want to keep the health. Then try to do all the household works by one. Okay, most of the houses, it was engaged with some of the servant maids, especially for cleaning vessels and maintaining the flooring and everything, and gardening, whatever it is. So there are 5 or 6 servant maids are coming. They are doing their own works and going. They're in the most of the houses in the town. Now, you have to try do all the household by one, and do little bit strength training. Don't search for any structured and weight, and you have with some of the object, even so many books, you know, you can tie with a rope and you can do some of the little bit strength training program. And also, if you couldn't find any time to do all these things, and you do yoga to maintain your health. Yoga means you can do asana, pranayama especially. Okay, because yoga has 8 limbs. All the stages one could not able to go through, and the one can able to do is asana, pranayama. Okay, and the last one also you can do is samadhi state, because the savasana and relaxing the body, so you can do it. And better to go for yoga to maintain the health. And after that, do some cool down exercises. In the first warming up exercises you have done. And now you have to cool down your system. First you have warmed up. Now you have to cool down your body by doing the same stretching exercises in a smaller intensity and a low intensity. In the warming up exercises, if you do 10 times means here you can do 2 or 3 times. That's all. Very low intensity you have to do as a cool down exercises. And what are the guidelines for the training program? You have to listen to your body and get adequate rest. Why I am insisting this thing, listen to your body, means your body will indicate some of the thing. Just a minute. You may feel some pain. You may feel some disturbances. While you are going for a training program, you have to listen. And then you have to get some adequate rest. That is more important. If you take rest, and you can do more exercises again and again. So that adequate rest is must. and cycle the volume and intensity of workups. What about the volume? Volume means total entire duration of the workout, and the intensity means how hard you are working. And try to train with a partner, because you will not get some monotonous. You will not be bored during this lockdown. We were not able to play regularly. And what we used to do, or my friend, what he has used means by his neighbor, he has had a walking regular of walking about 5 to 6 kilometers daily. If he wants to do individually, definitely he will not go for 5 kilometers, and he will go for 1 kilometer. So if you do training with a partner, that will be good. Okay, but the main thing is you have to maintain the social distance and vary your activities regularly. You change your activities, nature of activities. Okay, there is another terminology which is called cross training. Cross training means you can able to choose the same kind of activity. Okay, say for an example, a basketball player will play handball. Yeah, basketball player is playing handball means it is a cross training. If the handball player is playing basketball, it is a cross training. The own activity can be changed. Okay, then you have to train your mind, the psychological setup up. That is very, very important. As I told in the beginning of the class, okay, what we are, what we repeatedly do, okay. So whatever it is, we have to keep the psychological setup also, and fuel our activity appropriately. Fuel our activity means the duration, okay. Don't go for a very tired program. Don't go for very less program, and you should do all this physical activity with fun, and. You can track your progress by assessing self-assessment and keep the exercise program in perspective. Okay, so definitely this presentation might help you, I think so. Okay, thank you so much. If you have any clarification, you can, with the permission from the organizers. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Dear participants, if you have any questions, you can post the questions in the chat box, or you can ask him so that you can unmute yourself and you can ask.
Sure.
Yeah.
Sure. Yeah. I have 2 questions to our speaker.
Please.
Can I?
Yeah,
Dr. Anbu and Dr. Karthikeyan for a wonderful talk, sir. It's really thought-provoking. I have 2 questions, sir. One,
please, sir. Yeah.
Some 2 days back, one girl from Madhya Pradesh has got selected for pilot. She is a daughter of one tea shop owner in Madhya Pradesh. While his coach is talking about, she is a volleyball player. Within 2 weeks' time, she reduced 8 kgs by drinking water. Is it possible? My first question.
Okay.
Is it possible to reduce 8 kgs weight by simply drinking water for 2 weeks? That's my first question. Second question.
Can I answer first question?
Yeah, sure, sir.
Then we will move the second one. Okay.
Yeah, please.
Sir, as far as your question is concerned, it is somewhat technical with the nutrition concern. Okay. With their, if he has taken only, she has taken only water without any training program. I think she would not be able to manage herself. Okay. Without training program, that is without food, only by drinking water. If she did any other physical training program, it is not possible. She would not be able to survive. One. And there may be a possibility of reducing maximum of 3 to 4 kg. Okay. But for about month, as far as physical activities are concerned, as far as my knowledge is concerned, it is very hard to reduce 8 kgs within a week. Okay.
Thank you, sir. My second question is regarding during this COVID situation. Many sportsmen person has used to run for in miles together for to keep them fitness and to keep going in the marathon like races and all. So what is your advice now to keep them? They are in their home, they could not go out. So how to be in touch with them?
Fine, very good. I can quote an example of my friend Dr. Rakesh Tambar from he is from Delhi. Now he is working in Saudi Arabia, and he was my batchmate, and we have a closely associated one. And regularly he has participated in some marathon races in Saudi. And now what he is able to do with his home, okay, within his home, and he is doing some sort of 20 or 40 minutes running within his home itself, okay. Up and down he is running and he is maintaining his fitness. And as I told you in the while I'm presenting the thing, don't worry about the thing, whatever the that is environment you have. You can able to do the exercises within the stimulated area, but you can't able to do vigorously and effective, but you can able to maintain, okay. So for them, my suggestion is they can do within the stipulated area with a lesser amount of intensity to maintain the health or maintain their performance.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much.
Yeah, fine. I hope I fulfilled your question.
Sure, sir.
Participants, any other questions? You can post your questions.
Sir, any questions? Please post your questions.
Yeah, I think we can close, sir.
Sir, he is closer. Tomorrow, sir. Head of the Department of Defense Studies in our college.
Yeah.
Sir, Anbu, sir, we can close, I think.
Well. Okay, sir.
Yes.
Basic fitness, sir. It is very clearly explained, sir. Very informative and the excellent presentation, sir.
Thank you.
Now I would like to call upon our Thomas Professor, Dr. Kishore, to propose what of thanks.
Yeah, thank you very much, sir. So it gives me immense pleasure to propose what of thanks for this excellent webinar. First of all, I'd like to thank our secretary and bishop for permitting us to conduct webinars of this sort. Thank you very much. I'd like to next thank our principal, vice principal, for giving us the entire facility, choosing our topic and conducting and deciding your participant, whether it is national or international level, and they permitted us to do this webinar as such. So thank you very much to them. I would like to thank Bursar for giving us the infrastructure, providing us the infrastructure to IQC in order to conduct all these webinars. I would like to personally thank Dr. N. Anbu, our physical director, for conducting this wonderful session, because during this COVID situation, it made us to understand how to keep us really fit. And to place the credit for the Department of Physical Education, more than 120 students have been represented South Zone and All India University level for the last 4 years. So we'd like to congratulate Dr. N. Anbu, the physical director. I'd like to thank IQC team and Dr. Jay Kumar, the head of IQC, for coordinating this wonderful webinars conducted by all the departments of this college. And a very special thanks to Dr. Karthikeyan, Associate Professor of Annamalai University, for his wonderful presentation. So it was really amazing that we learned today, because one point which we liked most is that input and output should be proportionate. So it was wonderful. That's a wonderful message that you are leaving to us, and it was really superb. And one more thing is that physical activity pyramid, it also gave us many information about how we need to work on it, and the pyramid, it gives us more lesson. Really, it is wonderful, sir. And finally, you know, that the highlight point is that for the entire seminar, listen to your body. So yes. We usually listen to others, but first time I'm hearing the highlighted message, listen to your body. It was really wonderful, sir. So thank you very much. You have given us your time, your most valuable, and it shows your credit and your knowledge and wisdom on behalf of Department of Physical Education and URIS College and IQC team. We like to congratulate and thank you wholeheartedly. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much. And to the participants, I would like to congratulate all of you, because, you know, well, right through the beginning till the end, I can see participants are very active in the chat boxes as well. And in chats, you have given us your feedback. It was really fantastic. So all feedbacks I'm reading here, it's really wonderful session. So the chat box is full with your feedback. So thank you very much. Now I'll be sharing you the feedback link. You can fill it and take it. And on behalf of URIS College, we welcome you for future seminars as well. We have tomorrow and day after tomorrow we have two webinars. Like to invite you for those seminars as well. So thank you very much. And once again, I'd like to thank our resource person, Dr. Karthikeyan, Associate Professor, Annamalai University, and Dr. N. Anbu, Physical Director of URIS College. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. You, sir.